Earth may be surrounded by a huge magnetic tunnel. Jennifer West, a researcher at the University of Toronto's Dunlap Institute for Astronomy and Astrophysics. She's making a scientific case that two bright sources seen on opposite sides of the sky, previously considered to be separate, are actually connected and are made of rope-like filaments. These connections form what looks like a tunnel around our solar system. Ladies and gentlemen, fasten your seatbelts because we're going for a ride on the roller coaster crossing the solar system tunnel. Observations on the galactic scale shows us that there exists a fantastically large ridge of hot X-ray and radio-emitting gas that rises above the plane of the Milky Way. It seems to start near Sagittarius and extends to Scorpius, Lupus, and past Centaurus. To understand it better, just look at this picture. It shows us a new version of an all-sky X-ray map of our galaxy. One can soon notice a long, beautiful filament in the center of the image. That is the North Polar Spur. However, since its discovery, astronomers debated as to what it actually is. Long ago, a cluster of supernova bombs exploded relatively close to the solar system. Could it be the edge of the nearby local bubble blown out by this cluster? Or is it a cavity carved out by even stronger activity in our galactic center? It depends on its real distance. The trouble with this is that even though we can see the North Polar Spur on the sky, we don't know how far away it is. We are limited by this. Is it hundreds of light years or tens of thousands of light years distant? For astronomers, distances are the key parameter to understanding the sizes of objects in the universe. This means that as long as we don't know the real distance of the NPS, we can only make some estimates about its size. We'll probably have to wait for Gaia's mission, which is in the process of measuring the brightness, colors, and distances to a billion stars in the Milky Way. Its precious data could help us pinpoint the spur's location, and thus its source and its correct sizes. Accurate measurements all over the years showed that most of the North Polar Spur must be within 500 light years of Earth, and it is likely part of the Scorpius-Centaurus Association, a region of heavy nearby star formation. The local bubble was formed roughly 10 million years ago when a cluster of stars went boom. These supernova explosions were not close enough to affect life on Earth, but the solar system is inside the bubble. Anyway, we should be very careful with this kind of statement. For example, scientist Daniel LaRocca is not convinced the North Polar Spur is a local object. Instead, he thinks there are two structures that just happen to overlap in the sky, a nearby part and a larger, hotter structure that's much farther away. Whether near or far, the North Polar Spur is a relic of a bygone era, one that future investigation will help reveal more fully. Another kind of filament besides the North Polar Spur is the famous fan region. The fan region is one of the dominant features of the sky in the polarized radio continuum, long thought to be a local, D less than 500 PC feature. Some of the fan region emission originates in or beyond the Perseus Arm. The emission must therefore be produced along a large path length, suggesting the presence of a coherent magnetic field in the plane of the outer galaxy. Astronomers think the polarized emission from this region is a consequence of the structure of the galactic magnetic field and the interstellar medium. So let's sum up what we said. If we look up to the sky in the radio range of frequencies, we can see two bright large-scale radio structures on the opposite sides of the sky. They are the North Polar Spur and the fan region. We've known these structures since the 60s. Well, what Jennifer West suggests is that these two are actually connected and are made of long, magnetized parallel filaments. Moreover, this connection forms what looks like a tunnel around our solar system. Using her words, if we were to look up in the sky, we would see this tunnel-like structure in just about every direction we looked. That is, if we had eyes that could see radio light. But how did they find that? Before finding out the answer to this question, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel, clicking the bell, so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. The research team built a computer model that calculated what the radio sky would look like from Earth. Until now, the only models we had were the ones in galactic coordinates, and those kinds of plots were not so useful if we wanted to understand what was going on around our solar system. Now the new model allowed them to build the structure around the solar system and showed them what the sky would look like through modern telescopes. Can you imagine this tunnel? How do you visualize it? If you see something like this, you're probably on the wrong track. It probably looks more like a car tunnel. The only difference with a car tunnel is probably that we're not moving through it. The solar system is not actually flying through the tunnel. In this case, it's a lot more likely that the tunnel is actually stationary and is moving with planet Earth across the galaxy. Here's another way to try to imagine what all this looks like. If our sun is right here in the middle, you can see that there are quite a lot of these loop-like formations forming an almost tunnel-like structure, which from the top also might look something like this. With the tunnel itself being approximately 1,000 light-years in length, made up of charged particles and a magnetic field, the structures are shaped like long ropes and are located about 350 light-years away from us. At that distance, their size is about 1,000 light-years long, as we've already said. That's the equivalent distance of traveling between Toronto and Vancouver 2 trillion times, West says. West took her idea from a paper from 1965 when radio astronomy was born. Based on the crude data available at that time, famous astronomers Mathewson and Milne speculated that these polarized radio signals could arise from our view of the local arm of the galaxy from inside it. That paper inspired West to develop this idea and tie her model to the vastly better data that our telescopes give us today. Just try to imagine the Earth. The North Pole is on the top and the equator is through the middle, unless you redraw the map from a different perspective. The same is true for the map of our galaxy. Most astronomers look at a map with the North Pole of the galaxy up and the galactic center in the middle, West explains. An important part that inspired this idea was to remake that map with a different point in the middle. The new tunnel model not only brings new insight to the science community, but also a groundbreaking concept for the rest of us. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. What do you think about this video? Let us know in the comments below. See you soon on the channel, and remember to keep it curious.